HTTP message format. There are two types of HTTP messages, request message and response message. In this slide, HTTP request message is given. In the gray box, general format of an HTTP request message is given, while in the box below, its example is given. HTTP messages have four sections. First one is request line. The other section is header lines. Header lines could be one or more than one. Then there is a blank line, which is represented with the characters, carriage return, and line feed. And the last section is, fourth section is entity body. Request line has three fields. First field is method, which is separated by a space character. And after that, we have a URL field, which is separated by the space character. Third field, that is version field. And after that, line is changing. The characters used are the carriage return and line feed. Look at its example below. Request line here. The method used here is the get method. Those who are aware of the web programming will have experienced this get method. And then there is a space. You can see the space here. And then URL field there. And then the version of the HTTP given. And then line is changing. In our example, we have four header lines. Let's see the format of the header lines. Header field name. And then there is a colon, a space, and the value of the header field, and then line is changing. Look at the header field name, host, then colon, space, and the value of the header field, and then line is changing. In this header line, host means host given www.myschool.edu. Connection close, it means after sending the request, server can close the connection. User agent means web client is using which browser. So Mozilla browser is used here. And accept language, French. It means if the requested object French version is available, send it. Otherwise, default version will be sent. After the header line section, we have blank line section. Only a blank line you see here, a blank line. And then the entity body field. There, the entity body field is empty because the get method is used. In the previous slide, we talk about the get method. Beside get method, in the method field, we have many other options. Some of them we are going to discuss here. Get method. Get method is used when the browser requests an object with the requested object identified in URL. As given in the example, requested object, for example, searching for the monkeys and bananas, so monkeys and banana is given in the URL. The other example, the other possibility of the method is post method, which is used when a browser send data in entity body field. Look, post method will be used here, and the requested and the data will be sent in the entity body field instead of the URL. And post method, for example, we are filling some web-based form. In that case, our data is not going as a URL. Rather, it is going in the entity body field. Head method. Head method is like a get method. But when a server receives a request with the head method, it responds with an HTTP message, but it leaves out the requested object. What? Server is sending the response, but it leaves out the requested object. When it is possible, an example of it, location of the requested object has been changed. In that case, server is not sending the requested object. Rather, in its response, server is sending the new location, and then the client browser will retrieve the new object by itself. And put method. Put method allow a user to upload an object to a specific path or folder on a web server. For example, you are uploading your CV. Delete method allows to delete an object on a web server. For example, you uploaded your CV sometimes and then you are going to delete it. After the request message, now we are going to study the response message. General format is given above in the gray background, and then in the an example is given in the box below. Like a request message, it also has four sections: status line, header lines, blank line, and entity body. Their status line fields were different. Over here, they are different. First field is the version, HTTP version, and then there is a space, then status code, and space, and corresponding to a status code, some phrase. We will see its example, and then line is changing. Header field, its format is exactly same. Header field name, colon, space, value of the header field, and then line is changing. And then blank line, which is represented with carriage return in line field and entity body. So first example, status line version. Look, HTTP version 1.1 is used. Status code 200 is used and corresponding phrase is OK. Let's go and see its example. This is University of Wisconsin Milwaukee web page, which is saying 404 file not found. Actually, I wanted to retrieve the object file1.jpg, which is not found. So status code 404 and corresponding phrase is file not found. You all have experienced such type of messages. So header field name here, in our example, we have six header lines. First line is connection close, means after sending the response, server is going to close the connection. And then we have a date field, which indicates the time and date when the HTTP response was created and sent by the server. Then we have date field, which indicates the time and date when the HTTP response was created and sent by the server. Server field, which indicates that the message was generated by an Apache server in this case. Last modified field, which indicates the time and date when the object was created or last modified. So content length field indicates the number of bytes in the object being sent, and content type field indicates that the object in the entity body is HTML text. And then there is a blank line because the next is the blank line section, and then entity body object data will be there. In the previous slide, we talked about the status code 200 and OK. And now in this slide, we are going to study some more status codes. Status code 200 is being sent when the request succeeded and the information is provided in the response message. And then status code 301, its phrase is moved permanently when the object that is requested by the client has moved permanently and server is sending a response with the new location. Now this is the job of the client software to retrieve this object from the new location by itself. And then the status code 400, it means bad request, it means server cannot understand the request. 404 not found, it means object does not exist on the server. Status code 505 means HTTP version not supported by the server.